Frontline video journalist David Brill is an exemplar of the Tasmanian brand. Brill has demonstrated his bravery and mastery of the art of recording vision, as well as his compassion at every major world conflict in his adult lifetime. In a global action-packed life, Brill has never tired of promoting his state of birth to anyone who would listen.
I was always keen on photography and journalism as a kid. At Scotch College in Launceston, where I went to school, I was president of the Kodak Club at 14. Didn't know much about the future in journalism or news photography, but I used to love getting Life magazine and Newsweek and Time and all these picture magazines. For some reason, I felt this is what I wanted to do. And after a bit of training as a still photographer, I was lucky enough to get into the ABC as a trainee cameraman. And a few of the top cameramen at the time were away on holidays when those bushfires happened in 1967. I was sent out to film them, the bushfires. And I hated filming those fires and seeing people's homes burning down. I felt incredibly guilty. You know, I just, what am I doing here? I mean, so now and then I put the Bell and Howe camera down and go inside and drag out books and paintings just to make myself feel better. But I had a chief of staff called Beth Gregg, who was pretty tough, in a good way, very professional news person, that I knew I'd get spanked if I didn't come back with film. And so I kept filming as well. And when that film went all around the world, it brought a lot of expertise and aid into Tasmania.
His bushfire footage created a reputation for the fledgling cameraman. He found work in Sydney and was soon enveloped in the biggest news story of the time, Vietnam.
Vietnam was the biggest story in the world, and I was lucky enough to get to go and work on Four Corners. I had two great loves in those days, and professionally, one was to work for Life magazine, one was to work for Four Corners. Well, I managed Four Corners with Mike Willacy, who I considered and still consider probably one of the greatest news journalists Australia has ever produced, then on Four Corners. So he and I and sound recordist Rob Sloss used to go to Vietnam quite a lot. And that made an incredible impact on my life of what this war was all about.
Brill's 2003 biography by John Little was titled The Man Who Saw Too Much.
It's the people I've always cared about, the refugees. I can see them now when the war happens, all these thousands of people with nothing trying to escape the fighting. And I think they thought that maybe I'd seen too much. The work has never been really work for me. It's more than that. I don't say it's a calling, but it's a responsibility, I feel, done properly and with dignity of these people to show what is going on in the world. Being a cinematographer, video journalist, it's a huge responsibility to bring it back home and show the people. It's like a school teacher, but we get to a bigger audience. Education, education. I've been to nearly every, and I don't say this with pride, every major war or disaster in the world over the last 40 years, from Vietnam, Cambodia, Laos, all through the Middle East, all through Africa, even Idi Amin in Africa, South America, Central America, El Salvador, Nicaragua, Guatemala, the Falklands, I call it the Malvinas, Grenada, even up till today, and I'm 67, Iraq, and Afghanistan. Now that might sound as if, oh, you like going to all these wars. It's not that at all. They are big journalistic stories. Big. You can't go to a bigger story than a major war because it just doesn't affect that country. It affects the world. The reason I do say now and then, oh, I think Australia's a bit like Disneyland, because it's an incredibly lucky country. This beautiful big island with 22 million people. The older I get and the more travelling I do, I realise what an incredibly lucky place Australia is. It's democracy, the health systems overall, the education. I am a very proud Tasmanian. Every time I get off a plane and I'd smell that air and I'd think, golly, I'm home. There's just something magic about coming back to Tasmania, which I don't believe that the mainlanders, a lot of them, don't really understand Tasmania until they've been here. A hell of a lot does go on here in the arts, in business. Once I was flying back from Edmonton in Canada to New York, And I told the hostess, where are you from? I said, Tasmania, and I am the Tasmanian ambassador. Well, they moved me up into first class. And I thought, oh, well, this is very nice. Only to find out that the Governor General was up there from Canada, and I felt terribly, oh, God, he'll know there's no ambassador. So I asked him, could I quietly go back to my economy seat, just to get an idea. But it can get you into trouble now and then. But I mean it in good fun, as also of the pride of the place.
Because of his standing in the media, his international mobility and his passion for the state, Brill was invited to become a Brand Tasmania ambassador in 2009.
For instance, when I was in Afghanistan last year, there was a ceremony for the soldiers when the commanding officer was giving them all medals for their tour of duty in Afghanistan. So I got up and gave out, while I still sat into attention, some of them, when I had Tasmanian badges, I'd pin on them after they got their military badge. And they were chuffed to get these little badges of Tasmania. So by doing that, it does get people to at least have a look on the map or go into the website of Brand Tasmania and see what Tasmania does. If it wasn't for my work, I would have been back here years ago. But in the last couple of years, as I'm getting a bit older, I've moved on to another different contract with SBS. Instead of being on staff, I'm contracted to do 6 stories a year for Dateline when I can live anywhere. And so it gave me the opportunity to come back. And I love it here. It is very, very special. I don't say that, I'm not silly enough to say that because I'm a Tasmanian. I say that because of 45 years of roaming around the world, that this is a very special place.